was good. It was more of a teaching day. We brought in a speaker to talk to the guys, watched a little bit of film, worked on some cleanup, and then competed a little bit, at the end of practice, where we still need to get better at closing out games, which is where the playbook changes a little bit, and you got to be able to make the certain reads. So we focused on that in the competitive part of our practice.
Who's the speaker?
Ryan Holiday.
Okay.
He did a really nice job kind of talking. You know, it was 15 minutes, so you can't get too much in, but his messaging about some of the books he's written, I thought was great. Hopefully the players did too.
How much of a drawback not having Trevor and presumably Harry for the rest of the preseason? How much does that handicap you?
He's still Corey on that list too. Okay. It doesn't look like we're going to be getting him back in these next two games. So it's not ideal, but it's part of what the NBA is. So we got to get good at everyone being ready to step up, and that's why it's important to have a deep team, and it's important for everyone to be ready and know that they're valuable, because at some point in the season we're going to have to count on everybody.
Do you like the odds of getting any of those guys back for the season opener?
Yeah, I would hope so. We got a good amount of days there from our last preseason game to when we played the Suns, so I would be hopeful that we got at least one, two, all of them back, but we'll see.
What are some of those things that change in the late game execution in the fourth quarter that you have to work on that maybe aren't the same in the first three quarters?
Well, the game slows down a lot in the end of a game, right? So there's, as you're building your playbook out, there's some things that, we don't want to be an isolation team for 48 minutes. But the final 5 minutes, we're going to want, whether it's Harrison and Fox in a 1-3 pick and roll, or if it's, just space and let Fox have an angle pick and roll, whatever it is, wherever we feel like we have an advantage on, we want to be able to milk that. And that takes practice, it takes reps, it takes seeing how different teams will guard it and options out of that. So it was just kind of more of a focus of today's practice, since we were a little down in bodies and we played last night.
Can you take much from these early matchups with teams that you'll see early in the season?
Well, it's, for us right now, it's still more about what we're trying to do and establish. So, like I said last night, I was very pleased with the improvement we made defensively. We got killed on the glass against Indiana, and then last night we came back and we were much more physical. We won the rebound battle. We gave up high percentages from threes and twos against Indiana. Last night we did a much better job of getting those numbers down. So right now it's more about us getting better, but at the same time, you gain a little something. So many of these teams in the NBA are completely different this year, so you got to get a feel for the teams and who you're playing against. So it's that part of it you get a little bit from.
Luke, what's your reaction to Buddy's comments last night about his contract talks?
He signed a contract?
No, he's... You're probably aware of what he had to say.
That's, I think everyone knows we love Buddy, and that's, him and the front office dealing with that. So Buddy's been great. I think last night defensively he really stepped up to the challenge that we've been putting out there for him all game. From the first play, he was, chasing Booker around, who's an elite scorer in our league, and I thought that was I thought it showed a lot of growth from Buddy last night.
As a former player yourself, can something like that linger in the back of your head when you're trying to focus on the task at hand?
Being a free agent?
Well, yeah, or just contract.
Yeah, it's natural. It's there's always a human element to sports, and it's important that as a team and a culture, we recognize that, we support each other. We're aware of those things. But at the end of the day, we come down and we know our job is to play basketball, to win games, and that's the most important thing. And I think Buddy is I think Buddy knows that, and I think he has the ability to do a good job of focusing on the task at hand.